in there and tell them, listen, you know, I'm going out Saturday night and I want to paint my toenails silver, you know, and who cares? So it's the beauty of getting older. You know, the older you get, the less likely you are to worry about what other people are going to think of you, you know, so big deal. But you know, this stuff was like $6.95, right? For that much paint. So, and why did I get it? Well, because, you know, I looked and I go, you know what? I need a nice, beautiful silver and I need a blue. I was looking for a blue and I found this right away and I go, how can I not buy, you know, Mysterious Blue number 460 from I think it's Revlon. Yeah. Ended up paying like $24 for four little bottles of paint. So if you're gonna use nail polish, always be on the lookout for the cheap stuff, because that's, you know, if not, you might as well just buy, you know, testers or heck, House of Color. You know, you can get for $7.95, you know, $11.95, you can get 2 to 4 ounces of the stuff. But again, we go back to the original idea, which is what, you know, why nail polish? Well, because it's, you know, it's enamel, it's lacquer based often, and you can mix it with cheap lacquer and get outstanding results. And a little will go a long way. So, I mean, this will probably end up painting one model, you know. It's very thick, and but I'll show you how to work with it in a minute in the next video. In the little clinic. So, but you know, I don't know. Maybe somebody knows the history of who started using it. For example, recently I was watching Ted Chopper Lear. He's painting this, I think he's calling it the Speedy Bird. He's painting a custom Thunderbird, which is turning out beautiful. And he was talking about going to Rite Aid and finding this flip-flop chameleon paint, which is, you know, they're out there. So you can paint your models in flip-flop paint. The thing about it, the beauty is that you can thin it really thin and be able to apply these very smooth, thin coats, you know, almost the way that you can House of Color. They dry pretty fast, so you could do graphics with them, you could do tape, all of that good stuff. But again, like all paints, you have to be mindful of, you know, how to use them and what's in it and all of that. I don't know the chemistry of any paint line other than the stuff that I read about. So, but you know, you have to be brave and you can't just say, oh no, you know, I don't know how to mix it. I don't know how to thin it. I'm not going to use this paint line. Will it ruin my airbrush? No, it's not going to ruin your airbrush, in particular if you're using good airbrushes like, you know, Badgers, Pache, Iwata, any airbrush that can handle, you know, urethanes and lacquers, you'll be okay with it. I don't know about some of the other, especially the airbrushes with plastic casings and stuff like that, you know. So, again, you know, I'm not an expert at all of this stuff. I'm just a model builder and I'm sharing my opinions and my views. So, and that's what they are. You know, I'm not giving you a professional expert opinion on any of this. So, you know, and again, if you're using this and if you're using lacquer, I don't know when was the last time you've been to a nail salon. I know it's been decades for me. There's no reason for me to go to one of those places. But, you know, I have seen them at malls and stuff where the guys who are working with this stuff will have, and in my view, they're making a mistake. You know, you'll see them wearing one of these. No, big no-no. And they'll spend, you know, 20 years, 30 years painting nails for ladies and wearing this. And that's not going to cut it, my friends. You know, wear your full-out respirator. You're still working with lacquer. You're still, you know, putting particles into your system. So protect your lungs, okay? Protect your health. So anyway, I am going to, mix these up, thin them, and get them into my plastic bottles so that I can start using them. So it's going to be a multi-part series on how to use and paint. It's no different really than anything else. So this series of videos is just basically geared at making you lose your, you know, your inhibitions about mixing paints. We all go through it. But again, if you have information, those of you who are as old or older than I am, on where, you know, the first, and I'm sure somebody will know because there are historians of the hobby out there, who was the first, when did it get started? I'm willing to bet, it got started as soon as model builders got their hands on an airbrush. This was a choice right away. So probably in the late 50s, early 60s, maybe, you know, late 60s, early 70s, but they've, you know, people have been painting models with nail lacquer, nail polish lacquer for a long time. So stay tuned in. There's going to be a couple of clinics coming up, a lot of fun, and some other videos. So, you know, have a great day, and stay tuned in, please. The laboratory is on full steam now. All right. Bye-bye, my friends.